Nearly 2,000 children were taken from their families at the U.S.-Mexico border in April and May. New polls show a majority do not support President Trump on this issue. The administration is refusing to back down from this tough stance. White House correspondent Mark Irons reports. Good evening, Mark.
Good evening, Lauren. Catholic bishops and a former Republican first lady are joining the growing outcry over the detention of migrant children. President Trump continues to blame Democrats for refusing to fix what he calls a broken immigration system.
The United States will not be a migrant camp, and it will not be a refugee holding facility. Won't be.
Homeland Security Secretary Kirstjen Nielsen also defends the Trump administration's zero tolerance policy. It requires all migrants crossing the border illegally to be prosecuted.
We have to do our job. We will not apologize for doing for our job. We have sworn to do this job.
Under the law, if a parent goes to jail, their child doesn't go with them.
It is important to note that every day in communities across the country, if you commit a crime, the police will take you to jail, regardless of whether you have a family.
And today, President Trump argues it's not always parents caught with the kids. He tweets, "Children are being used by some of the worst criminals on earth as a means to enter our country. Has anyone been looking at the crime taking place south of the border? It is historic, with some countries the most dangerous places in the world. Not going to happen in the U.S." The president calls on Congress to increase border security and close immigration loopholes. First Lady Melania Trump adds her voice to the debate, saying, "We need a country that follows all laws, but one that governs with heart." Former First Lady Laura Bush published her scathing opinion in the Washington Post, writing, "I appreciate the need to enforce and protect our international boundaries, but this zero-tolerance policy is cruel. It is immoral." And today we're hearing from the Vatican. It says children are suffering the most from forced migration. The comment comes in conclusions released after a Vatican-Mexico conference on international migration, but the statement made no explicit reference to the Trump administration's zero-tolerance policy. Lauren.
White House correspondent Mark Irons, thank you.